Howdy, folks, and welcome to 15 Nautical Mile ARC. Today we're back in the Marvin aircraft, which locally is incorrectly known as the Rozo Jet. I talked about this aircraft at great length and how Marvin flies it and Really Fly 2 videos ago. So I'm not going to take the time to do that again. So if you want to hear all about Marvin windows and their airplanes, just go back 2 uploads and watch the beginning and then come back to this video. So in the previous time we flew this aircraft, we talked about how they fly between Minneapolis and War Road several times a day. And they also fly to Fargo occasionally, I would say twice a week, maybe just once a week. And we're going to do that leg now. So we're going to go from War Road to Fargo. And then in a later video, we'll go from Fargo back home to Minneapolis. One thing I did want to point out, different from the other video, is I have not updated the tail number to 660. I still have 640 because, again, when I made this livery, they did not own a 1900D. They only owned a 1900C. But now that they own a 1900D, its tail number is 660. So I'll probably fix that and re-upload it to the org forum as version 1.2 or something, just so that it can be completely accurate to real life. So anyway, I'm not going to redo an introduction, so again, just watch the video 2 videos ago, and you'll find all about this airport, all about this aircraft, all about Marvin windows, etc., etc. And let's hop on in. All right, it's raining, and there are rain textures. As soon as I do the wipers, though, that'll go away and it won't come back. So I'm going to wait to do the wipers until long as I can. I did remember this time to turn the lights on for the people who are boarding, including testing emergency lights. Whoops, looks like it turned the reading light off on accident. Let's have a look at that. It's on. Let's go back. Now it's on. That was a weird bug. Clearly saw that it was on. Anyway. All right, so we don't need anything else up there for now. We'll turn that stuff on in a bit. Anyway, let's come down here and let me get my startup checklist ready. And I apologize about the fuel thing. If you remember from the last time I flew this aircraft, again, 2 videos ago, I talked about the fuel and how it isn't seem to be modeled unless you mess with the switches. And I have not looked into messing with the switches, mainly because I forgot. If I don't write things down, I forget. So our fuel, once I give us fuel, is going to stay where it stays and it's going to look like we're not consuming it, but we are. I just wanted to point that out. In fact, I'm going to do that right now since we're talking about it. We only need, oh my gosh, how much do we need for this one? You know, I think we're going to just stay at what we did last time. Just because we're going to have heavy weather, we might have to go around storms. Oh, I didn't mention that. I turned on moderate storms, so we're using SkyMax Pro version 3.2 for the clouds, but in the sim I turned on moderate storms. So you can see there's a storm over here. You can tell because they touched the ground. And as you fly along, we'll get more storms. I was going to do heavy storms, but I'm kind of a little too tired to fly around storms. Maybe in another video I will crank up the storms and fly around them manually, but that's not going to happen today. We will get radar here, though, I believe, if I remember right. It's been a while since I've used that for weather. All right, well, let's really get started now. So we turned on the external power, and we're going to turn on all of the cabin lights now. Once you get in the air, we can turn these down. All right, we're going to turn on the appropriate lights. Actually, let's get the battery going first here. Flip that cover up, turn on the battery, get that charging. We'll hear the sound in the background. And I also want to turn that on. There we go. Now we can turn on any lights we need. Let's turn these on so people know we're around. Turn that on, and seatbelt sign, and everybody should be boarded by now because we're going to be starting the prop soon. We'll keep the reading light on. We'll turn off the floodlight. So now we have this appearance. Whoops, I turned left my emergency lights on. Let's turn those off to normal. All right, that's all we should need up there for now. I will do the wipers in a minute. I said I just don't want to do it until we're ready to go, or else we'll lose that nice texture. All right, so we're going to turn on our EFIS, which we have to bring autopilot down. And this is buggy. I mentioned that every time. We'll turn that on, and we'll set up autopilot later, too. All right, we're going to enter our flight plan now. So, see, here's our weather. We have a little bit of weather here. So a storm when I loaded the sim was over here and it's moving away. See, it's moving away. You can see it pixel by pixel going away. Anyway, we'll get more storms once we move along and start regenerating weather. So that won't be a problem. All right, flight plan. We need a flight plan. We need a menu. We need to clear that out. Delete flight plan. Yes. And I'm distracted. And I think we can go like that. There we go. Now let's enter this. Our first place we're going to go is rocks. We're going to go to the over the Roseau VOR. And I can't talk and do this at the same time. I'm sorry. There you go. Enter. We'll go there. Yes, we're in the US. We're not going to the Philippines today. That'd be nice, but not today. All right, then we're going to go to the Gixxer. Again, the United States. These all mean things. And I don't know what these mean on this trip. I knew what Blue Ox meant on the previous leg, but I don't know what these mean. Indigo, and last but not least, Romeo. So, all right, next. We're going to just pop out for this because this is taking too much time that way. Although, that's a fun way to do it. All right, and then we're going to begin our approach to the airport. So, we're going to go to Muli or something like that. Got to remember how to do it, though, without scroll wheel. So Muli, right? There's Muli, and there we have to be 3,500 feet. So then from there, we go to Kiene or something. Okay, well, I'm trying to use the published approach to KFAR, which is Fargo, Hector International. And Muli to Kane. And then at Kane, you drop to 2,500 feet, and that's where you pick up the ILS, and then you just follow the glide slope. So we don't have that here. So there's an alternative I wrote down. I always write down alternatives. Let's try Roto. But there's a missing letter there. That's only four letters. I thought that looked strange. I got this from Sky Vector and the flight plan, or and the approach chart. And Sky Vector, there's a Roto. But it's missing a letter. So I guess we're just going to go for Muli. And then we will just descend until we catch the glide slope, I guess. That's a bummer. In fact, I don't even know if the ILS is in the sim. It wasn't for Rhodes or for War Road where we are now. There was a ILS over life, but not in the sim. We'll see here. So let's just put in the airport, I guess. And we will just wing it. If worse comes to worse comes to worse, we'll just do a visual approach. There's KFAR. Yes, we'll accept that. We'll do direct to there once we're in the air because we're not going to have air traffic control to get us there. So, but we'll do that in a minute. No, I can do that right now. Forget it. I'll just do that right now. How do I get up there from here? Nope. It is a big one on the pop-out. Okay, direct. Yes. And then we now have a direct. Okay, so that'll work. Let's pop that back in. So let's set up the ILS. It's going to be 108.9er, so let's see if I can remember how to do this. I have to pop this out too. Nope, it's down here. Oh, that's the wrong one. I want this one. Nope, that's... We got to hit V. We got to get this down here. Do we push? There we go. 108. Oh, come on. Niner, right? 108.9er. Switch that. We will do CDI to follow the GPS, and when we get to glide slope range, which we will know because I'm going to put it in this VOR as well, we will then switch our GPS over to VLOC, and then we can hit approach on the autopilot until I'm done being a big chicken, and then I'll kill autopilot by minimums and land. All right, so let's go over here, and let's put in our nav 108.9er. Have gone the other way, I know. Niner 108.9. If you go the wrong way, puts into memory. There we go. 108.9er. Alright. So we got the flight plan in there. We're gonna land on runway 18. That's the thought, unless the winds are too poor, and then well, we want to set our heading bug to 176. So let's do that right now so that we know what we're looking at. Actually, we want to both set to 176. If you try to do from here, I think it gets all messed up. Oh, yep, see, it's jumping around because of that whole glitch thing. So let's jump down here. Let's put them both on 176. The bright pink so I can see it. And then the other one so that we can line up with our glide slope. I set this so we can have a visual here when we do the ILS, but in case there isn't an ILS in the sim, I have the bright hot pink bug as well, so I can see what I'm doing. Let's have a look outside. What is going on? No, we're just under a cloud, under a storm cloud. That's all. All right. We're going to have problems running out of battery here. It's taking me a while. All right, so we got the flight plan, GPS. We got our VOR stuff set up. And the reason I'm doing that, I mean ILS, the reason we have to do an ILS now is this is a very short flight. I could have done that later. I could have waited till we're about to descend, which, by the way, we're going to descend 7 minutes out. I plan on cruising at 14,000 for this. Or 7 minutes out from Muli, anyway. So I could have done that later, but it's going to be such a short flight. I just wanted to do it now and not worry about it. So let's get going right here so we don't run out of battery and stuff. We need to close our doors and the baggage and remove the static elements. And now we're going to make sure our props are all fine. Get my yoke stuff. Make sure it's working. There we go. Set trim. Although, if I go too fast, it goes the wrong way. Okay, we'll do that. All right, we're in feather. All right, we're gonna start the engines now. So we need to turn this off apparently. And we're gonna hold the ignition and hold the starter. And once it gets to, what is it, 12 or 15, it doesn't really matter. 15%, I'll crank in the fuel. But I only have one fuel access on my yoke, so it's gonna bring up fuel for the other one as well. We'll turn on that generator. We're just gonna get this started here. Let's start the other one. Let that take off here. Let go of that. Generator, lower the guard. Let's come over here and watch that prop spin up. That is a really dark cloud. Remember from the beginning of the video, it wasn't that dark. I do have cloud shadows cranked way too high, I think. I might mess with them a little bit more. Alright, we got that going. Alright, let's see what's next. Come back down here. AC bus, turn those on. Go over here to the co-pilot side and do our bleed air valves. Let's give us a little bit of heat. They don't need to be 40 degrees here. Put that on auto, it's gonna get to 110 and then we'll turn it back down later. That's test. So let's see what we're gonna do. Rudder boost is between the seats. If we wanted to do cabin pressure, that's there. Ooh, do you hear the thunder? I hope you heard the thunder. Climate, auto feather to arm. Auto feather to arm. Generator ties closed. Anti-ice install and all of our heats. Yeah, let's turn that on. Auto, okay. Prop sync on. And we are ready to go. So let me put that down. Let me readjust myself on my seat. I have a stereo recorder, so you might hear me moving around. All right, I think everything's set. So I have our flight plan planned, and I have our approach already planned. So that's why we've been sitting here longer than normal. I like how you can hear things. I assume thunder would be louder too. All right, let's turn these wipers on a second. Let's go to slow and then park them. And turn them off. And you now see we have a nice clean thing. And I don't think that reaccumulates. I think once you wipe them, it stays that way. But you know what? Because it is raining, let's just put them on slow. I've never used wipers in any aircraft, so I think we're set. It seems a little bright in here. There's something going on. What I need to do is go through these very slowly. I know what those two do. I just need to go through them slowly. All right, we're going to taxi. And we are going to get out of Dodge. We have no warnings. Just auto feather. That's expected. All right, let's taxi outside just so we can see everything. And this whole peripheral vision thing. So we need to make a sharp U-turn and go there, because that's the way the wind's going. All right, hooray for the worst taxi ever. The shortest and worst. See, my rudders are like backwards or something. Alright, here we go. Runway's clear. Let's hop on in here in a second. Alright, we'll stop right there, set the parking brake, come on inside, we'll put our props all the way forward, we'll come up here and turn on our landing lights, and we'll turn the taxi lights off, and we'll come down and see how annoying those wipers get. So I want to fly at 14,000 here. And we want to use nav, and we want to climb about 2,200 if it'll let us, and there's alt select. So that should be all we need there. And now we are ready to go. So take off the parking brake, hold the brake, throttle all the way forward, and away we go. There you can see the sun peeking out between the clouds a little bit, shining against the clouds. And no flaps because this runway is ridiculously long. There we go. Take off. Gear up. And we'll get situated here. We'll get some speed just like we did previously because we can. And we'll turn left manually ourselves a little bit just to get started, or else we're going to crank really hard with autopilot. And I don't want autopilot to be confused and turn us the other direction, because that will happen sometimes. Let's not go quite so steep here. And engage autopilot. Alright, I'm hands-free. That's pretty good. It can't even tell to take over on the banking. Do we have a look out the window at our airport? Nope, it's already behind us. That's okay. Alright, so we're heading towards the Roseau VOR, which is 3 minutes out, actually. And flaps are up. Autopilot is set. Landing lights will keep on for a while. We may go above. We may go above 14,000, we'll see. Just looking back towards the city of Warroad and Mbatet in the background. No airport from here. Alright, let's turn these wipers off. We don't need to see where we're going, really. Whoops, wrong way. Park them. That'll set them back. And then you can go like that. So if you're going along and you go to stop, they'll stop in whatever position they're in. You go to park, it'll park them. That's what that means. And I'll turn in a little bit to get back to Rosa. We have to do engine management soon, or else we will start on fire. Roseau Airport is right there. The VOR is at the airport, so we're going to cross right over the airport. All right, let's dial back our engines a little bit. I don't want to burn up. I can't remember what the time limit is. Oh, we're in the rain again. A little bit, and then it's gone. All right, so I'm looking for it's green everywhere. Go a little bit higher there. Very, very small movements. You can't even see my hand moving. And then bring back the props a little bit. And we're at 95%. So we've got green, 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 green. Doesn't matter, doesn't matter. If we go over to our fuel, they're going to stay there the entire time. They're not going to move until I start, I assume, until I start messing with this. I talked about that at great length in the previous flight on this, so I'm not going to waste that time again. And anyway, I think we're all set. Ideally, you want to memorize or look up your percentage here for climb instead of doing what I did and just look in the green. You really want to know what your that is and then double check with the green. But otherwise, we're at 8,000 feet climbing, so you've still got a head start. Of course, this will come down to 140 eventually at 2,200 feet per minute, but we got a head start in our speed, so that helps a lot. You can look out. And the this is interesting. So with storms, your visibility is down, and the way it's drawing that looks absolutely hideous. I've never seen that issue before. Oh my, that's horrible. What is going on? I'm going to check my weather settings. I'll be right back. Right, that's a little better. Ooh, there's some nice lightning. I'm not sure why he's doing that. Those of you who watched my SkyMax Pro video a couple back, we did this exact scenario with storms and visibility, and that was not happening during that video. So I'm not going to worry about it too much. We have more interesting things to think about. All right, 42 seconds from Rozo. And I think we're going to have an outside look. Oh, there's some storms. See how they come down to the ground. Have an outside look. Oops. Sun between the cloud shadows. That's cool. All right. Now we'll have an outside look and watch us go over the Rozo Airport. So looking back, oh, I see what it is. Okay, this is the end of the cloud shadows, because the clouds are only, the weather is only generating this far, so my cloud shadows are stopping there. So let's have a look at Rozo first, and then we'll and Dexter Rozo's back here. There's Rozo. Airport, city. I'm going to turn down my cloud shadows, and I bet that'll take care of that. So I'll be right back again. Okay, yeah, I was right. So off camera there, I turned my cloud shadows off, and it rendered perfectly smooth all the way to the horizon. But then we wouldn't have any cloud shadows. So we'll keep the cloud shadows on for now. Just because I like the cloud shadows, although it doesn't seem to work too well when you're flying around in moderate storms, because then you're kind of overcast, kind of not. It looks much better there, because the clouds aren't going that far. But this is mainly a problem because the storm rendering is only out this patch. My cloud draw is out like, I don't know, what was it, 60 or 70 or 80 miles or even more than that, but the storms that the sim is generating clearly stop right here, and I can't make that longer. I already have that turned up all the way. So we're just going to live with it. It probably works much better for VFR flying than flying at altitude, but whatever, we'll live with it. I really hope we get closer to these storms. There's one right there. If you watch, you'll see lightning from time to time. Are we really at cruising altitude already? I want to get above these clouds. We might have to make some changes. We are. Well, okay. Let's get above though. Let's see. We got 20 minutes. Well, less than that. And that is to Jixer. And then we got to start coming down. Could be Mealy. So we really don't have a whole lot of time to fly much higher than this. But I want to do it anyway. Whoops. Let's get down there. Kind of like when you fly to Chicago from Minneapolis on a commercial flight. And you, still fly at 38,000 feet or 34,000 feet. It's just by the time you go up, you come right down. So here we can see the weather. Still not very accurate. Like, you can't see that storm. Must be off here. I guess you have to expand that view to see it. Anyway, let's bring autopilot back up and let's climb. So let's climb another 2,200. And then alt select, yada, yada, yada. Why won't this go away? Because there's a glitch. Oh, you can see weather there too. I didn't know that. There's a storm up there. Look at that guy. We're going to fly right into it too. See what I'm talking about here? Right there. I'm not going to go around. I'm going to fly right into it. I want to. Now we're talking. Now we're doing what I wanted to see. All right, cool. We'll just enjoy the view. There's the hail and the rain. looks like we have a little bit of turbulence here. If we were to pop up and look at our radar, I'm sure we're going to see that we're in the yellow. Wow, that was loud for me. How about you? I apologize. But I do not apologize for this beautiful view. Now, I was reading about autopilot, and I was reading when there's strong turbulence like this, and storms, is quite often, I guess, pilots will disengage autopilot because of the turbulence. But for storms, you would just be constantly changing your course to go around the storms, but I want to fly right through them. They're only moderate. Maybe I'll do a realistic flight some, or a different type of flight someday where I turn the storms way up to severe, and then fly around them that way. That'd be fun. That looks awesome. Let's see if our windshield is picking up anything. Nope, sea is clear. Once you use your wipers, it stays clear. That's what I thought. Alright, so let's see. We got 16 minutes yet. But that's because we're still climbing. Nope, we're at 17,000. So that, let's look over here at our weather. Looks like we got another big storm off to the right, but we'll probably go around it. Oh, that looks so awesome. I'm tempted to look outside, but I'm afraid we'll see how much we're shaking around here. Oh, isn't this just great? I just love this. Now that's looking well into... Oh, I'm sorry, Canada's behind us. I'll say that's looking at Canada, but no, it isn't. Canada's behind us from this direction. It's a bummer that the storms only render so far, and you can see the shadows end. But now it looks less ridiculous. I also have it set to morning, by the way. I suppose if I set it to afternoon, this wouldn't be a problem. In fact, let's do that quick. Yep, see? It's afternoon and now it doesn't look as silly. Let's go back to morning though, that was better. I wanted a morning flight. Whoops. I don't know, where were we about there? Yeah, we'll leave it at that. Alright. Oh, we're gonna go right over a storm. So there's some red on there. So I guess this leg is also experimenting a little bit. It's not just a simulated flight, but we had a simulated flight the previous leg. So we'll just keep going, chugging away. Alright, we can probably turn our engines back up here a little bit. I don't need to be that low or that slow. Going here. Whoops. Don't want to go over 99 and a half, probably. There we go, in the red. Barely, but we are. Alright, well, now that we've figured everything out and we've talked about everything and we understand why the shadows look so crappy and all that stuff, I am going to step away by from talking and we're just going to, fly along. No background music again because I want to hear the sim sounds and I want to share those with you. So I will check in with you. For me, it'll be about 20 minutes. For you, it'll be a 5 or 6. So we'll see you in a little bit. Alright, I'm checking back in with you a little bit sooner than I'd planned. I'm going to start coming down a little bit because I don't know the actual time from Gixxer to Mealy, and we got to get down to 3500 by Mealy. So I'm going to come down to our... I'm going to come down about 12 or so if I can get there. And then we'll have a more detailed look. Oh, that looks nice. Let's look at that a second. You know what? No, we do have to come down. We'll look at it in a second here. All right, so we want to descend at... Let's do... Let's do 1600. Descend. Alt select nav, yada, yada, yada. I'm always obsessed about making sure it says alt select because there's been a few times that I've climbed and or descended right through my intended altitude. Wow, that looks nice. So I'm glad I got those shadows figured out on that rendering thing, so it wasn't a rendering problem after all. And if you look down at the bottom of the screen, the fuel has not moved. So there we go, we load the clouds. There's a neat little cloud fluffy going by there. Some turbulence, as I expected. That's why we went so high earlier, but I don't know. I don't know how soon it is on the next one, so... Well, there's some storms going by us. We seem to be doing a good job staying around the storms without having to manually interfere. We can stay right on course. That just looks so fun. It sounds so fun. A lot of good visuals on this trip. And I'm doing this on a 24-inch 1080p monitor, by the way. I'm a little sad that the cloud and storms and shadows don't go beyond, but I imagine the CPU and GPU load would just make your frame rates go to nothing. So at least here we're in the 40s or so. Oh, no. I'm looking at certain clouds. No, we're not in the 40s. We're probably in the high 20s. I don't know. All right, time to pay attention. 38 seconds. Whoa, that made me jump. I have my sim sound in my headphones turned up really loudly to the point where my kids will run up to me, and I won't even know they're running up to me and they're kids, so you can imagine that. All right, 17 seconds. We're going to turn, and then I get to see if we need to panic and descend more or if we'll be okay. 10 minutes, and we need to descend 7 minutes out from 14,000. We're at 13,000. Alright. That's nice. So we got a couple minutes before we can descend. Alright, so it looks like the storm ends up there where the shadow stop, but it'll regenerate and it'll keep going. Alright, so we'll sit at 12,000 for another minute or so, and then we will prepare to start our descent. And as soon as we get to Mully, we're aiming for 3,500, then we immediately have to get down another 1,000 or so. And we need to intercept the glide slope at 2,500 feet above sea level. And in case there is not ILS, I have the GPS program. If there is ILS, I'll switch over to VOR, VLOC, and hit approach so we can start our glide slope, and then once we're established, I'll get brave and land manually. Although I did a manual landing from a difficult turn landing into War Road, and I was fine, except for that wheelie I popped. Speaking of that, there's not an airport modeled when we get there. KFAR is not modeled as far as I know. If it is, it's a surprise because I don't have custom scenery there. And it's not on the gateway, and it's on my to-do list for the gateway. So I'd be shocked if there's scenery. I'm not expecting it. All right, 3,500 will be our target. We have this going up. All right, we're 10 minutes out. We can start our descent. We'll just do a slower descent. So we'll come over here, and we'll do descent, but we're not going to do 1,500 like normal. We'll do 800 for now, and then when we get to about 7 and 6.5 minutes, we'll do 1500 descent, because my descent calculations is based on 1500 feet per minute. Looks a lot less threatening, this low below the clouds, though. There's a storm over there. So right now, if you want to know where we are heading pretty much due south, which, with North Dakota on this side of the river, and Minnesota here, and this is the river here, and then we're basically, well, that, you know, basically right there is where we're going. That should be a runway, actually. So we're just going straight in, pretty much. Alright, let's see how we doing here. Still got some time before I need to worry about our descent. Oh, that's not our runway, that's our river. But our runway is gonna be, it's gonna look like that, sorry, when we get there. I thought that was a little close yet. Silly me. Alright, let's have one more look outside before we have to manage our descent. Looking good with the clouds around us. Alright, let's turn our landing lights on now. We should be close to 10,000. Yep, 9.9. Pretty good timing there. Alright, time to accelerate our descent a little bit. So we'll go to 1,400 since I can't do 1,500. Even numbers. And I'm going to keep our throttle up because I want to get going. I don't want to hang and linger in the air. I want to get going. So we'll keep descending. Middle of nowhere, upper Midwest. This is pretty much what it looks like. There's nothing until you get to Roseau and then War Road. Of course, there are tiny towns, but they're tiny towns. Otherwise, it pretty much looks like this. Of course, in real life, this would be the rainfall you're looking at, but it looks like a cloud here, but it sure looks better than default cloud. And alright, where are we at? 3 minutes away. Whoa, we're reaching over speed. I'm not paying any attention. My overspeed horn didn't turn on. Alright, 3 minutes, 3.5 minutes. And, 3,000 feet to go, so that's 1,000 feet per minute, so we'll make it. 36, 35, VS is turned off. Come back down here, we'll switch this to 24. I'm a scaredy cat, I don't want to be too high, I'd rather be too low, as funny as that sounds. Come back over here. See how long we have, and then we will set our descent rate accordingly. We'll actually start slowing down, although it's going to be very easy to bleed off speed in this thing. So I'm not that worried about our speed right now. When these things land at Minneapolis, St. Paul, with the big guys, they just fly, no pun intended. They just book it until they get to the runway, then they lose their speed because they have to keep up. All right. Sure, I'm not doing much sightseeing right now, but I really want to fly the plane this time and not run into stuff. Plus, you've all seen the storms now, and you've seen the. Okay, we got to go down fast, and you've all seen the clouds and the rain and everything else. So let's slow down a little bit. Expect to catch that glide slope soon. I'm not sure why we're not, so I'm actually... Oh, no, there we are. We're lined up. Check it out. That's the runway. Not that. So we will descend, I guess, not quite that much, to 24. And as soon as we hit 24, I'm going to go over to the localizer. There we are. Cancel the alt alert. Our speed should taper off now because we're going to go up. I have not increased the throttle. Alright, we must be on the VOR by now. There it is. And I should be able to hit approach. Unless, see, that screws us up. It's gonna go up for the glide slope, isn't it? I should have waited until we met the glide slope. Oh no, it's leveled off, it's fine. So now all I need to do is manage my speed, my flaps and my gear, and then at some point I will get brave and turn off autopilot. You know I'm kinda kidding. I've been landing this thing manually in all my videos, so. Plus you can't land in this. You can get to minimums and then you have to land. This isn't a Cat 3C or Cat 3B aircraft, I don't think. Alright, there it is. Minor adjustments. Everything's looking good. I think we can do our first set of flaps then. And should probably do gear down. There we go. That's going to make us float, and then it's going to try to correct and all this stuff. I'm just worried about my throttle. As you can see, autopilot isn't perfect, right? That probably would have been a lot smoother had I done that myself, because I could have kept it from floating up like that. Now it's hunting to go back to 2400, or not 2400, but to catch that glide slope. That better give us a lot more throttle. All of a sudden, what's going on? There we go. Approach speed is 110 knots, and then 100 knots right before you land, and then you land at about 86 or something like that. This is going to be a huge runway. This is an international airport. They do land full-size jets here. Looks like the sun is coming out after the storms, though. That looks nice. All right, let's slow down a little bit. Second set of flaps. So now we need to approach at 110. We are lined up on the glide slope. Again, it's compensating for the flaps coming out. It's floating, and then it goes back down, and then it goes too low, and then it comes back up. Gear is down. Let's have one final look outside at everything. Oh, that is supposed to be water. I thought it was a rendering problem. It's like a type of farm or something. See some storms in the background. And we better hop in and land our plane. So I'm going to kill autopilot. And here we go. I shouldn't really have to do much. It should have trimmed itself. 500. And it did. Okay, let's not look around because I feel like we're going off to the side. Let's slow down to 100 knots. And we're a little more than 500 feet per minute, so we're too low. A little more throttle. Again, it's the whole... the rain came back on the windshield. It's the whole one hand on the throttle, one hand on the yoke thing. Now we're too high because I was looking at the windshield. Someday, I promise you, I will focus on landing while I'm landing instead of this looking around while I'm landing stuff. But it's exciting to see that the rain is back on the windshield. All right, that's our perfect approach speed. So now we want to land slower, though. We just want to... Whoa, that startled me. I about jumped out of my seat. Here we go. All right, let's not... We're doing a wheelie again. Come down. There we go. Smoother this time. There we go. I'm going to use reversers just because I can. We don't really need them. All right, we got to do some management here. Let's get those wipers back on. And let's get the taxi lights on. I gotta look down quick. Yeah, okay, now we'll turn the landing lights off. Come back down. There we go. So I'm thinking what happened is when we went through the rainstorms and you could see the rain on the airplane, that's when we got our rain back on the windshield. I'm not entirely sure. All right, let's have a look outside though, because it's more fun. I assume that's water splashing, because I don't have the brakes on. It has to be water splashing. Bringing in the flaps because I have plenty of time. Man, there's only one place to vacate back there. That was it, wasn't it? Oh, there's one right there. Okay, we'll go over. We'll go over there and park. Let's hop in so I can actually do this here. You can hear the rain on the body of the aircraft, though. And you can see the rain falling. It's straight down instead of across because we're not going too quickly. I can actually see better like that, can I? There you go. There's a taxiway and park here. I don't know this airport yet well enough to know where we would actually be parking. I don't know if that's a jetway over there. At least we have a 2D airport to look at. So this is double wide, so I'm assuming there's something on the right or the left. So let's just park here. Spin around and park here. Have a look. Should be about there. So, set the parking brake, have a look. There we go. Alright, we won't turn everything off until we're done with the replays, because replays mess things up sometimes. So let's have a look at our landing. We're about over the threshold. See the rain pouring down, and you can hear it on the aircraft again. And I'm actually over the center line. I can't believe it. There we go, good approach speed, perfect landing speed, the thunder that made me jump, and I reacted, and we're just going to ride a Willy down the runway, and slowly let it down that time. There we go, alright, let's check out our runway view. There you can see the nice storms in the background. So I could have been a little better about how long I kept the nose wheel in the air, but we had plenty of runway and I didn't jam the nose gear down like the last time I flew this thing. We are coming in middle of nowhere. Of course, Fargo is in North Dakota on the border of Minnesota. It is not in Minnesota. There we go. So our wheels are on the ground, but we're getting the stall horn because the nose gear is up. Go. Couldn't even tell when we touched down though in the front. Awesome. Alright, let's have a look at let's go back to real time and have a look at shutting this thing down. Alright, here we are, so we'll go back up and we'll park our wipers. And we'll turn our lights back on for our folks here. Actually, we can probably kill the engines while we're doing this. Seatbelt sign can come off. Keep all that on and turn the taxi lights off now. Come down here. Let's see. Let's hook up to external power if it'll let us. Should let us. We can turn some of that off. Will that kill everything? Nope. Good. That's exactly what he wanted it to do. We don't need anything else here. I guess we could turn off some of this stuff too. Turn off our GPS, I guess. If I can remember where the button is. I think it's that one. I thought it was that one. Power, yeah. So somehow that would simulate power. You do use that to turn it on. I guess you don't use it to turn it off. All right. Good enough for me. Let's open our doors here. And we'll have a look outside. We're not going to walk outside this time. We'll just have a look outside. Why don't you open that up, get some fresh air? Someone had lunch and it was stinking it up. Alright, let's go outside. Alright. Oops, I forgot to turn some of my lights off. We'll keep our tail light on. We'll keep our strobes on because we're on the ground and people are deboarding. So. Alright, well, it was kind of a mix of a flight. It was a simulated flight, but it was also a play around flight. I ended up playing around with storms and visibility and shadows and stuff during the flight, but I'm learning as I go. That thunder, man, that gets me every time. But we finally flew in some storms in the morning, late morning storms, which do happen in Minnesota quite often. And I don't have any umbrellas for these folks, but hopefully their cars will show up soon. So we'll have a couple different flights, and then we'll revisit this aircraft with this livery at least once more, flying back to Minneapolis, but we'll do a couple different flights in between, so that way it's not like the same flight three times. If this is the first time you've seen me and you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. If you're a regular viewer, thank you for sticking with me, and we will have some more videos very, very soon. I've been trying to upload every 5 days or so in the summer here, and we will catch you on the next one.